Hello, welcome to Computer Networks online lecture series. Myself, Reema Rawal from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Electronics and Communication. In this session, we are going to start the unit Medium Access Layer. And in this unit, today's topic is Channel Allocation Problem and Multiple Access Protocols. So let's start the session. So first of all, let us see what is channel allocation problem. So there are two types of channel allocation problem or channel allocation strategies. First one is static channel allocation and the second one is dynamic channel allocation. Now, as the name suggests, in static channel allocation, the channel allocated to the particular user is fixed, whereas in dynamic channel allocation, the channel allocations are different. So let us see the first one, that is static channel allocation. So in static channel allocation scheme, a fixed portion of the frequency channel is allotted to the each user. That means a particular user is assigned to a particular channel using which it can only transmit. Next is, in this allocation scheme, there is no interface between the user, since each user is assigned a fixed channel. Using that channel only the user has to transmit. If the channel is not available or busy, it cannot transmit for the next data. Now next is dynamic channel allocation. So in dynamic channel allocation scheme, frequency bands are not permanently assigned to the users. Instead, channels are allotted to the users dynamically as needed from a central pool. That means from the all the available channels, a particular user can use any of the channel available from the central pool of channels. That means, unlike static channel allocation, the fixed channels are not used for fixed users. Instead, any channel can be used for transmission by any channel, by any user, when the data has to be transmitted. The allocation is done considering a number of parameters so that transmission interface is minimized. Now, let us see the multiple access protocols. So, the first multiple access protocol is Aloha. Aloha is widely heard multiple access protocol, where Aloha stands for Abramson's Logic of Hiring Access. That means for accessing the channels, how the logic is established, that is the first multiple access protocol, Aloha. Remember the abbreviation, Aloha stands for Abramson's Logic of Hiring Access. Now, in the 1970s, Norman Abramson and his colleagues at the University of Hawaii devised a new and elegant method to solve the channel allocation problem. Their work has been extended by many researchers since then, that means 1985. He has derived the logical access for hiring access. After that, the name Aloha is there. Now, there are two types of Aloha protocols. The first one is pure Aloha and the second one is slotted Aloha. we are going to see pure aloha and scouted aloha, the difference between these two, how the channels are assigned to that, and what are the efficiencies or throughput in each of these cases in detail. So let's start with it. Remember that there are two types of aloha, pure aloha and slotted aloha. So first one is pure aloha. So the basic idea of an aloha system is simple. That means let the users transmit wherever they have data to be sent. So here, as you can see in this diagram, there are users A, B, C, D, E. With respect to time, they are transmitting particular frames whenever they have any data frames to be sent. Now, here as you can see in this diagram, we are considering the case where two frames are colliding. That means in pure aloha cases, this can occur when the transmission of frames are there at particular same time interval. Because in pure aloha, the data will be sent according when it is arrived. So let us see the frame 1 and frame 2 here in this part is transmitting correctly. If this frame is not arrived, the frame that is not shaded are received correctly. But as you can see, at the ending of that frame is collision with particular this frame, and the starting of this shaded frame collides with the first frame. Now, as collision occurs, three of the frames will be lost. That means if the shaded frame was not transmitted or it is avoided transmission during this time frame, then the two frames will be received correctly. But as the time collides, three of the frames, that means starting of the shaded frame with the first frame and ending of the shaded frame with this frame, collides and the data will be lost. This occurs in the pure aloha case. To avoid this, we can give the time slot boundaries in which the frames is transmitted so that we can avoid the collisions. So let us further assume that the probability of k transmission attempts per frame time, old and new combined, is also using a Poisson's distribution with mean g per frame time, and the probability that k frames are generated during a given frame time is given by the Poisson's distribution, which is given as PR of k, that is equals to g raised to k into e raised to minus g divided by k factorial. This is the equations for Poisson's distribution of transmitting the frames, where k frames are generated during the frame time. Now, so the probability of 0 frame is just e raised to minus g. In an interval 2 frame times long, the mean number of frames generated is twice of g. So the probability of no other traffic initiated during the entire vulnerable period is thus given by p0, that is equals to e raised to minus 2g, and using throughput s, that is equals to gp0, we get the equation throughput s equals to g into e raised to minus 2g. Remember that the equation of the throughput for pure aloha is given as s equals to g into e raised to minus 2g. This is using the Poisson's distribution equation. Now, the maximum throughput that occurs at g equals to 0.5 with s equals to 1 by twice of e, which is about 0.184. So we can say that the efficiency of pure aloha is 18.4%. So in other words, the best we can hope for this channel utilization is 18%, or you can say 18.4% using pure aloha. So this is the efficiency of pure aloha. Now let us see the next, that is slotted aloha. Before starting slotted aloha, I will tell you that the efficiency of slotted aloha is twice to that of pure aloha, that is 36.8%. Why? Let us see. So in the slotted aloha, as the name suggests, time slots are given to each user. So in this, time is divided into discrete intervals, each interval corresponding to one frame. So this approach requires the users to agree on slot boundaries. One way to achieve synchronization would be to have one special station emit a peak at the start of each interval like a clock. So here the throughput S is given as G e raised to minus G. We have seen in the pure Aloha case that was S equals to e raised to minus twice of G. Here in this, that is S equals to G e raised to minus G. Remember the throughput equation for both the cases. Slotted Aloha peaks at G equals to 1. We have seen that pure Aloha gives the peak at Z equals to 0.5, but slotted Aloha gives the peak at G equals to 1 with a throughput of S equals to 1 by E, or about 0.368, that is twice that of pure Aloha. So due to S equals to raised to minus G, we are getting the throughput 0.368, that is double to that of pure Aloha, which was 18.4, or you can say 0.184. If the system is operating at G equals to 1, the probability of an empty slot is 0.368. The best we can hope for using slotted Aloha is 37%. That means we say that 36.8%, it is approximately 37% of the slots empty, and 37% success and 26% collisions. So using this kind of strategy, there are chances of 26% collisions that may occur. Now, let us see the throughput versus offered traffic for these Aloha systems. We have seen pure Aloha and slotted Aloha. Let us see the comparisons of this. So here in this diagram, the graph is indicated for pure and slotted Aloha, where the throughput versus attempts per packet time graph is given. Here, for pure Aloha, the peak is at G equals 0.5. You can say that here in x-axis, G is indicated. That means attempts per packet time. And S, that is throughput per frame time, is indicated on y-axis. So in pure Aloha, G equals to 0.5, where peak occurs, where throughput is G raised to minus 2G. And in slotted Aloha, that is G raised to minus G, where peak occurs at G equals to 1. Right? Remember the efficiencies for pure Aloha and slotted Aloha cases. In pure Aloha, the efficiency is 18.4%, and in slotted Aloha, the efficiency is 36.8%. Alright? Let us see the comparison between pure Aloha and slotted Aloha. So let us consider the first parameter, that is transmission parameter. So in pure Aloha, any station can transmit the data at any time, whereas in slotted Aloha, any station can transmit data only at the beginning of any time slot. That means at particular time slots which are allotted, the data transmission can take place in slotted Aloha. Second parameter is probability. So the probability of successful transmission of data packet for pure Aloha is G e raised to minus 2G, that we have seen and which is important to remember. Now, same probability parameter for slotted Aloha is, so the probability of successful data transmission for data packet is given as G e raised to minus G. Now, coming to the next parameter, the maximum efficiency parameter. So the maximum efficiency for pure Aloha is 18.4%, as we have obtained 0.184 value, and for slotted Aloha is 36.8%, we have obtained the value 0.368. Next parameter is time. So in pure Aloha, time is continuous and is not globally synchronized, whereas in slotted Aloha, time is discrete and is globally synchronized. So in this session, we have seen the pure Aloha, slotted Aloha concepts and the difference between these two. That is very important to understand. I hope this concept is clear to you now. These are the references you can refer to. Thank you. Thank you for listening.